actually overheated.
Oh, oh no, the wind.
Ah, the wind blew it over. Ah. Yeah, we had a string line on the one end, so I got some slack action. I'm gonna see if I can get her to pull. Fortunately, the coupler came uncoupled, which pulled the plug so that you don't have a runaway. Or I was going too fast, one or the other. Right now, the engine and the vast car is straight across from each other. They're 16-foot radius curves. There's the end, and the engine's coming right around the curve already. I'll have to put a mid-train helper in, I think. And I know the headlight's not on. I gotta reprogram that engine. It's going the other direction. The slack action's really cool when you back this sucker up and you pull it forward. Most of them have 830s on them. Some have 789. Katie coupler or a knuckle coupler from another company. Okay, I slowed it down on that S-curve south of here, and so that looks like we're going to make it all the way around. They're two of the older Aristo Dash 9s, and they have the extra weights in them. I always put extra weights in my engine. Okay, we actually made it. As you can see, and there is the engine. Hard to see out here in the sun with these digital cameras. So, finally reached it, 25 years or whatever after the 100 ton hoppers came out. I finally got a 100 tons or 100 cars. Watching everybody. Now let's see if we can get to slack action. Whoops.